Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through one marker questions from the topic permutations and combinations. So here are the list of questions for permutations and combinations. We'll go through them one by one. The number of ways in which 10 people can be seated around a table, right? When you see it's a table or it's a garland, that means it's a circular permutation, right? Because table is representing a circle, garland is also representing a circle. So you'll have to use circular permutation formulas. There are two formulas for circular permutation. One is distinguishable and one is indistinguishable. That is, when I have people sitting around the table, I can distinguish them, right? In whichever sequence or order they sit around the table, you can identify who is sitting where. But when it comes to a garland, say a flower garland, right? Would you be able to identify one flower with respect to another flower? Say you have a garland of all 9 flowers with same colors. Right? Would you be able to identify which flower is where? You can't identify, right? Because all the flowers look the same. So this is an example of indistinguishable. That is, you can't distinguish. Now, in case of distinguishable, normally in cases of people, right? You'll have to use this formula, n minus 1 factorial. And in case of indistinguishable, you'll have to use n minus 1 factorial by 2. So now, here there are 10 people. That means n is 10. So formula is n minus 1. So 10 minus 1, which is 9 factorial. Now in the second one, the number of ways 9 flowers of different colors be strung together to form a garland. So in a garland, you'll not be able to distinguish between clockwise and between anticlockwise. You'll not know which direction the flower is. Because if I keep moving the garland, you wouldn't know, right? If I keep moving the garland, I wouldn't know which is clockwise, which is anticlockwise, where the flowers are. Is it in the clockwise direction or in anticlockwise direction? I will not know how the flowers are placed. So that's why this becomes indistinguishable. So we'll use n minus 1 factorial by 2. N is number of flowers, which is 9. So 9 minus 1, which is 8 factorial by 2. The third type is the number of triangles that can be formed out of 20 points from which 8 are collinear. Now there are a set of formulas here for finding the number of polygons, finding the number of diagonals, finding number of triangles, finding number of straight lines. So there are multiple such formulas. All those formulas you need to understand, just not this one, right? You have to go to the list of formulas which is there in the book. Now, one of them is you have to find out the number of triangles given 20 points, out of which 8 are collinear. Collinear means they are in the same line, right? Like this. They are in the same line. They are called as collinear. Now, so the formula is NC3 minus KC3. N is total number of points. K is collinear points. So 20 is total number, 8 is collinear, 3 because it's triangle. A triangle has 3 points, so it's 3. So you find this and you'll get the number of triangles. Now similarly, how do you find the number of diagonals in a decagon, right? Now, the general formula for finding diagonals is n into n minus 3 by 2. This is the formula, right? For decagon you have 10 sides. You need to know n. What is n? N is equal to 10. Decagon is 10 sides. So you'll substitute n as 10 and you'll get the number of diagonals. Now, another one. The number of triangles that can be formed out of 8 non-collinear points. Non-collinear means you have points anywhere, right? Like this. Right? So, how many triangles can you form with this kind of a pattern? The formula is simple combinations formula. You have 8 points and you'll have to form triangle. Triangle requires 3 points. Out of 8 points, you'll have to use 3 points and form a triangle, right? So 8C3. Remember one thing, whenever it is non-collinear, use this 8C3. If it is collinear, use this particular formula. Now next one, in how many ways can 4 people occupy 6 vacant chairs, right? Simple, you have 6 chairs, you need to select 4 people, 6P4. Why is it permutations here? First person can sit in first chair, second person can sit in second chair. There is a sequence, right? So that's why we'll have to use permutations here. It's not selection. We are not selecting 4 people. We are positioning them. So whenever we are positioning them, it becomes permutation. Next one. How many different arrangements, this word will tell its permutation, can be made with the letters of the word Monday. First, you should know number of letters. Number of letters is 6. Then you have to always find the repeated letters, right? Repeated letters. 6 factorial by repeated letters. Here, nothing is repeated. Therefore, nothing will be there in the denominator. Assume it was something like this, hooray. Just like that, just for an example. If it was like this, hooray. Then number of letters is 6, but you will have to put 2 factorial because r is repeated 2 times. So 2 factorial. So remember this, right? Always remember to put the denominator with repeated letters. Next one, find n if NC8 is equal to NC7. Now there is a property in combinations, right? If NCR is equal to NCK, then n is equal to r plus k. That is, if you have something like this, n and n is same, NC8 is equal to NC7, which means n is equal to r plus k. That is, you add up these 8 and 7. So when I add 8 and 7, it will become 15. So n is 15. Another one, if NP4 is 360, find n. Now this is little tricky because you'll have to find n. Now I don't know what number of n will give me 360, right? What does NPR mean? N into n minus 1 into n minus 2, it will go on r times. That's the definition of NPR. Now I have NP4. That means it will go 4 times. N into n minus 1 into n minus 2 to n minus 3. 4 times. Now, how do I figure out the value of n in such a way that I will get 360? This you have to do using trial and error. There's no other shortcut. You have to use trial and error. You start with n as 1, take 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? In 6, this is working out. When you multiply with 6, with n as 6, you'll get 360. How many different 4-digit numbers can be formed using the digits? These digits. No digit being repeated. Right? So first draw this box. 4 digits. So first digit, how many digits are here? 7 digits are here. So in the first place, you can put one of the 7 digits. So you have 7 choices to make. Right? You can choose any number out of these 7 digits. So 7. And second digit, again, 1 is already selected. It can't be repeated. 1 is already selected. So you're left with 6. And for third, 2 are selected. You're left with 5. For last one, 3 are already selected. So you're left with 4. So you multiply all these, right? You multiply all this finally. So this is the number of ways. This is in case of not being repeated. What if it was repeated? If it was repeated, straightforward. 7, 7, 7, 7. This is what will happen in the case of repeated. If it is repeated, just... because you can repeat, right? So even if I've selected one digit here, I can still select the same digit here. So here also I'll have 7 choices. Here also I'll have 7 choices. Here also I'll have 7 choices. That's why it is 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. Right? Now here, if NC4 is equal to NC5, then find the value of N. Similar to the other one. You have to remember this property, right? If NCR is equal to NCK, then N is equal to R plus K. So add these numbers, 4 and 5, it will become 9, so n becomes 9. Here also similar example. Now, here you have to find x if... Now, this is slightly tricky, but there is another property in combinations which will say ncr minus 1 plus ncr is equal to n plus 1 cr. Now, this and this look similar. 10cr, this 10cr can be written as 9 plus 1. Which is nothing but n plus 1. And r is 7. Right? R is 7. Now, here again, you have 7 here. So, you can... r is 7 already. Right? Instead of ncr, you have 9c7. And here, it is 9cx. We need to find x. We don't know x. But based on this property, this another number should be r minus 1. Based on this property. You have ncr. You have n plus 1 cr. You just need r minus 1. So, we know that r is 7 here. Right? Using this here, r becomes 7. It's understood that r is 7. So here it is r minus 1. What is that? 6. 7 minus 1 is 6. Therefore, x is r minus 1, which is 6. Now, last one. Number of straight lines that can be formed from 10 points if none of them are collinear. If none of them are collinear, right? How many straight lines can you form? Straight lines will have 2 points, right? Straight lines will have 2 points. So the formula should have 2. So it is nothing but directly you have 10 points and you need 2 points to form a straight line. So 10C2. That's all. So with this, we have come to the end of this particular one marker video for permutations and combinations. If you have liked this video, do press the like and share it. Thanks for watching.